Working from home has many challenges, and now people have to rely on their own devices to access resources back at work. So this means they type passwords more frequently, they log in on services more frequently, and this makes them more exposed to threats like phishing and scams and other social engineering attacks. The use of home devices now poses another problem because our security administrators cannot really secure them in the same way they would secure the devices and the computers back at the offices, right? So this is another challenge.
A lot of people, probably more than 50%, are using their handheld devices and their tablets as their main computing devices, right? So they are less and less turning to their desktops and to their laptops. No matter how expensive your phone is, it can never be too large for you to hold it in the palm of one hand. When you're looking at a website, there's not all that much space really to render this site and to show it to you. So browsers make these choices in their user interfaces to maximize the real estate that they give to web pages. And so while they're doing this, they may make choices that are harmful from a security perspective. The web browser may actually hide the URL bar. The problem with this is that attackers can actually detect that. And so you could actually have a fake redirection to another website that says this is facebook.com and asks you to log in. But in fact, this is still that site, which has now drawn a fake URL bar that looks like it says facebook.com and is just taking advantage of the fact that your browser is hiding its own real URL bar.
People are certainly aware of malware and spyware and things like that. But sometimes people don't think so much about when they download and install apps. Most people, you know, don't think about it at all. They are often convinced that if it's in the app store, it should be safe. Or if it's somewhere on the internet and the browser doesn't tell them anything that this is bad, that it's okay to download and install. This is, I think, one of the biggest sources of problems.
You always need to be cautious when you're receiving an email or an instant message, but now you have to be doubly so. If I get an email from someone and it's a little bit suspicious, in the past perhaps I could walk over to that person's desk and ask them, did you really send this? There could be cases where someone falls for phishing attacks, falls for social engineering attacks where they wouldn't fall before. With every email that asks something that seems sensitive, like click on this link, download this, fill in this form, send us this, do this action, really learn how to identify the sender of an email. And when in doubt, do not act.
So users have to be vigilant. It's a good idea to use two-factor authentication whenever a service provides this. Use stronger passwords, and of course, always be vigilant and be cautious whenever you have to open something from an unknown source or, you know, visit a website that you have not visited before.
And what I would say is best is if each organization, each company, can actually communicate and create a working from home guide. Here's where you will find the software. Here's where you have to download it. Here's how you should install it to use in this remote setting.